Good evening. People kept talking about taking photos, so that's what I was waiting for. I've been patron of lots of things. I've never actually been patron of a particular concert before, but it's really exciting for me. I'm really looking forward to it. It's going to be a fantastic evening. I've already seen the programme. My job at the moment is to be principal of the Royal Birmingham Conservatoire, and I really enjoy saying the Royal Birmingham Conservatoire, because it's only like 2 weeks ago that we were given the royal title. It's because one of the reasons is because we opened a brand new conservatoire. It's really bucking the trend. It's a £60 million investment by Birmingham City University, which we're part of. And I think it's a wonderful thing that they've done, because it has to be admitted, although we're all very positive and very uplifted tonight, that music education is under threat at the moment, particularly with this present government's persistence in their EBAC, which has removed all arts subjects from the school curriculum, and to the detriment of our children's education, in my view, because I think children deserve a rounded education. They need to come out of school with more than a very narrow knowledge of a few subjects. I don't think it helps them in the future. I don't think it helps their careers, and I don't think it helps their well-being. So it's wonderful to see these musicians tonight, and we should fight for these things, you know. It kind of has become almost a kind of quirky, odd thing to do, perceived in some circles, to go to a classical music concert. But it isn't. It's something people enjoy, and we should be allowed and encouraged to do that. You know, I still travel a lot. I've traveled for years as a performing musician till I had an injury. But I'm still traveling, and 3 weeks ago I was in China, and the money that they're putting, the investment they're putting into music education is, compared with us, is absolutely mind-boggling, really. And I can see a situation where tables are turned, and we have a lot of Chinese students at the Birmingham Conservatoire, but I can see people from the Western countries going out to study classical music over there. So that's an incredible about face. We need to get our act together, I think, as a country, and get behind music, because it has so much to offer people. So I don't want to be negative anymore. I just want to say, let's enjoy a fantastic concert. And if you are cross about the cuts, write to your local newspaper. I see that there's a huge number of local sponsors, the radio stations and things. Bombard them with complaint. Make it a talking point. I see the wonderful Melvin Bragg is a patron here. He said something very interesting not long ago. He wrote it, actually, that he thinks there is a sea change in public opinion. I know that, you know, when Jeremy Corbyn made a speech just the night, I think, before the election in North Wales, he said every child should be given the opportunity to learn an instrument. Now, in the old days, that would have had a little bit of polite applause, a sentiment like that. But it actually got a massive cheer from this huge crowd in North Wales. And I think, as Melvin Bragg wrote, culture defines a nation. That's who we are. That's what we are. It's not money, numbers, and, you know. It is actually what we produce. You remember the Olympic ceremony? What a fantastic occasion that was when... you know, we had James Bond and Simon Rattle and Mr. Bean, and these were English or British artistic products that are known, well, not products, but you know what I'm saying, known throughout the world. And that's what identifies us as a nation. And I think there is a change in mood now, that people are beginning to perceive that, and it's not, we have to be careful about this narrow school curriculum, because it's so easy to destroy something and so difficult to bring it back. And I mean, the Norfolk Music Hub are just doing a wonderful, wonderful job, as you will hear tonight. I'm so pleased to be here to support it. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm going to play for you an unknown piece called In Ireland, well, it's not unknown, it's uncommon, called In Ireland, and it's by a guy called Jonathan Harvey.
Thank you. first movement of Barber's Violin Concerto. This was composed in 1939. It wasn't actually performed until 1941. This is because it was commissioned for a crotchety violinist called Iso Braselli. Despite the fact that he loved the first two movements, he actually did not like the last movement because he thought that the stars didn't match, there was no correlation to the other movements, so he refused to play the piece. But lucky for you, I'm just playing the first movement.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the talk. I'd just like to point out there's a change to your programme. Francesca could not make it this evening, and the violin will be played by Abra Heritage. Thank you.
Thank you.
is Ava, that's Harry, and that's Esther, and we just performed the finale of Opus 76, number 5 of Haydn's String Quartet. This was written while Haydn was employed by Prince Nicholas Esterhazy in Vienna, and this set is one of the most adventurous works that he has composed, and it was written at the same time as when he was working on the creation. We're going to play another piece, and the second piece we're going to play is Notturno from Borodin's second quartet in D major. So this is one of the most famous movements of this quartet, and it was used in 1953 for the Broadway musical Kismet. It was written in 1881 when Borodin was in his late 40s, but finding time for it was almost impossible because of his day job as a Russian scientist, and he even has a chemical solution named after him, which is the Borodin reaction. And we were thinking of using that for the name of our quartet. So we hope you enjoy it, and thank you for listening.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. and dark